Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, my dear students. A warm welcome to your biology class, and this is your biology teacher again from United Public School. So, students, in our last class, we have seen our TS of chloroplast, and we have discussed about light reaction, which is a part of photosynthesis in chloroplast. Photosynthesis occur in chloroplast, right? So, it is a light reaction and dark reaction, light dependent reaction and light independent reaction. Both are a part of photosynthesis process. So by the end of the light reaction, we have get our end product, that is NADPH and ATP, that is nicotinamide arenine dinucleotide phosphate and adenosine triphosphate, as you can see over here. Remember this flow equation, like chemical equation like this. It take water and it will finally we will get our end product, that is NADPH and ATP. So by this we have completed our light reaction. Okay, in light reaction means in presence of light only the reaction will start, the reaction will initiate, the reaction will execute. Okay, by the end we have get our end product, and we will start our today's light independent reaction, that is second event. Okay, actually there are three events taking place in chloroplast, that is during photosynthesis. Remember this three events. In that three out of three events, first two events are taking place in light reaction, and third event is taking place in dark reaction. Remember, as it two reaction takes place in light reaction, but still dark reaction is a large process. It is a large process, but in your today, in your this class, you have only a little bit information, that is enough for your today's. Okay, so that is enough for your this class. So let us start. This reaction does not require presence of light. Extinction of phase during daytime may occur in some plants. So as I said, light independent reaction, in the sense it does not require reaction without light, that does not require light. Without light, the reaction will be go on, it will be in process. Okay, and the continuation of phase after the daytime will also occurs. It does not require light in the sense the reaction would take in daytime, you think, right? But not like that. In daytime also the process will be in progress. So it will continue. So this is also called as dark reaction. But the term dark reaction does not mean that it occurs when it is dark at night. So as I said, the term dark reaction does not indicate that the reaction will only take in light. Night. So the reaction will also take in daytime as well as in nighttime. So clear now? Daytime as well as nighttime, this reaction takes place. It does not require light. That's it. So in the dark phase, the hydrogen combines with carbon dioxide by utilizing ATP energy and produces glucose, that is C6H12O6. So this what happened during this reaction, the hydrogen which is present in air, the hydrogen which is present in plant, it utilizes carbon dioxide which is present in air, and it uses ATP. ATP energy is nothing but light energy, and it produces glucose. Okay, see over here the hydrogen, yahan pe sirf hydrogen ko dekho, hydrogen utilizing carbon dioxide and ATP energy is nothing but light energy which is come from sunlight, and it produces glucose C6H12O6, right? It is producing glucose. Then after, the glucose will converted into starch in plants. Okay, तो प्लांट्स के लीव्स में स्टार्च प्रेजेंट रहता, बल्कि हम लोग एक्टिविटीज में कंफर्म करे थे ना. सो ग्लूकोज विल कन्वर्टेड इनटू स्टार्च. दिस इज प्रोसेस ऑफ स्टार्च कन्वर्टिंग ऑफ ग्लू लाइट एनर्जी एंड ऑल टू स्टार्च. ओके, so this synthesis occurs in a number of steps, usually several special intermediate compounds and enzymes. These in synthesis in the sense producing something. So we are producing glucose, and glucose is producing converted into starch, right? So the synthesis this synthesis step occurs in special intermediate compounds. There are several enzymes and compounds helping in these steps, so that we will not discuss in this class. In your further upcoming classes we can discuss. So this much of information is enough for your this class. So finally, glucose में कन्वर्टेड इनटू स्टोरेज प्रोडक्ट दैट इज स्टार्च. एज आई सेड, फाइनली ग्लूकोज विल कन्वर्टेड इनटू स्टोरेज. ठीक है. एंड हियर प्लांट्स आर कैपेबल ऑफ सर्वाइविंग अंडर ए रेंज ऑफ सिचुएशंस. ठीक है. फ्रॉम वेरी हॉट ड्राई एंड ब्राइट लाइट कंडीशन टू वेट ह्यूमिड रेमले लाइट कंडीशन. सो प्लांट्स आर आउटसाइड लिविंग थिंग्स, राइट? आउटसाइड लिविंग थिंग्स. सो दे कैन एबल टू सर्वाइव इन एनी कंडीशन, इन रेनी सीजन, इन समर सीजन, इन हॉट सीजन, इन विंटर सीजन, इन एनी सीजन इट कैन बी सर्वाइव, राइट? प्लांट्स कैन बी सर्वाइव बट नॉट ह्यूमन बींग्स कैन सर्वाइव. So in any season the plants can survive. So the requirement of light and other factors vary from plants to another. ठीक है. So plants are capable of surviving at any difficult or difficult conditions. So it requires different other factors, various factors which we won't use, right? So this information is about light independent reaction. So what is it? Just recalling us that the photosynthesis occurs in chloroplast, right? And it occurs in two phases, that is light dependent reaction, which is also called as light reaction, and light independent reaction, which is also called as dark reaction. So this is our overall reaction in terms of words, and this is in overall reaction in terms of chemical equation, right? These both are same, but this in terms of wordings, English wordings, and this in terms of what we say, chemical equations. So what happened? First of all, light energy is taken by the plants, and by the help of water, it will produce NADPH and NADP, and the NADP is catched by NADPH and producing NADPH and ATP, or the end product of light reaction. And what happened in over here? You had light reaction converted into chemical reaction. Then in here, over this reaction, chemical reaction will convert it into chemical energy only, but in synthesizing new product. The photosynthesis takes place from here to here. It is continuing process, not a different process. It is continuing process. As I said, this indicating the dash dash arrows indicating this process is continuous process of photosynthesis. But we have divided this into two events. So we have to take this end product in here, and we have to utilize by utilizing carbon dioxide combined with hydrogen. We can produce glucose, and this glucose again can later convert into starch. So here is our overall what we will utilize. We will utilize carbon dioxide and water and light, and we will produce in glucose and oxygen and hydrogen we will produce. Okay, these are the reactants means which we react, and these are the end products. Kya kya humko milta at last, that are nothing but end product. So our next topic is heterotrophic nutrition. This heterotrophic nutrition comes under nutrition only. As in our starting of our lesson, we have discussed type of nutrition, that is autotrophic and heterotrophic, right? Remember students. So autotrophic are the plants, and heterotrophics are the organisms which are dependent on the plants or any other materials, right? In autotrophic, what happened? Photosynthesis in chloroplast occurring. We have synthesized glucose, and we have converted glucose into starch, as I said. Okay. But what happened in heterotrophs? In heterotrophs, we will utilize this starch. Hum heterotrophs. We human beings comes under heterotrophs. We eat this plant, right? So we use this starch, and we will convert this starch into this. As this starch is very complex, we can able to digest our body and are unable to digest. So in our body, starch is converted into glucose in simple form of starch. So in order to digest this starch to get energy to our body, we have to convert this starch into simple form of starch, that is glucose. This process occurs in heterotrophic organisms, and the human beings comes under holozoic, right? Human beings comes under holozoic. At the starting of the lesson, I explained you. And we human beings also take proteins, carbohydrates, which starch, all these are complex complex. So we have to convert this complex into simple form, and we have to digest it in our body. All the process will take place in our body only. And in the living organisms are capable of surviving under different conditions and acquiring their food in different way. So in this world, in this whole world, all the living organisms can able to survive in different conditions. So and they can get their food in different ways, right? To survive, they have to get their food, and so they struggle for their food, and they build capable, they are capable of surviving in this living world. So we have already studied about the organisms that capture light to produce food, that is the plant, right? We have studied, right, the plants capture light and produces food. Okay, they are autotrophic in nature, that are autotrophic in nature, as I said, while those cannot prepare, that are heterotrophic. So we are heterotrophic, we can't produce our food, we have to depend on plants or some other animals. So we are holozoic. Under heterotrophic, we are holozoic. So students, this is your today's assignment, right? Light reaction, dark reaction, and overall reaction in chemical equation form. I have written over here. Take a screenshot of this picture and do your homework. Okay, and submit in your groups. Okay, chalo. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.